Sports. It's in the game.
Stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
I heard somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a what's a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework, I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling.
No more feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling.
Hey, Belly, them ready?
Yeah. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's
them
just how
I'm feeling. Them get a red eye, never make right. Me, they are something like.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And wow, a gamble here right off the bat. An onside kick to begin the game. Good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it. Now there's two sides to every coin. You come on the road, you get the onside kick to start the game. What a boost, but you don't get it. And now your back's against the wall a little bit.
You're exactly right. You nailed it perfectly. And so many ways to go at it when you're on the road. You think to yourself, well, if we start on defense, we blitz them early, try and create a big play. If we start on offense, we throw the big pass downfield. In this case, they said, forget all of that. Let's do it on special teams and try and catch them off guard with an onside kick unsuccessfully.
And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. Now Ryan. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And the Buccaneers are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid, the turnover on the first possession.
I love how you use those college-bound words like that, inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that. But here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. It's Eric Harris who picks it. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. After the interception, here's Ryan. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. To throw is Ryan. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Complete, and he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
This one was all about clearing space for this play to work because he's going to leak out of the backfield to his right and then angle his way up the field. And a really pretty throw to put it on him and create the big play downfield.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And the Bucs are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line. Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at about the 32. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's complete to Tyler Johnson. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Throwing on first down is Brady. He'll swing this out to Fournette. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Brady now on first down. He finds his target. It's Evans. And down inside the 15 he goes. Into the red zone. It's Brady. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And shedding through the tackle. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Here we go now on first and goal. They'll try and run it in with Jones. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the 1. Second down and goal. Brady. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And the Falcons are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Patterson on the carry. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. We're scoreless after 1. Back now in Atlanta, 2nd quarter action. The Falcons with the football, as they've got it with a 3rd down coming up. Now it's Ryan. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now 4th down.
This offense has definitely been slow getting out of the gate. It's almost like they missed their wake-up call for this one. No points on their first 2 possessions. And now it's looking like none on this one either.
So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. This is taken at the 18. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Bucs are going to take over 1st and 10 deep in their own territory. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously...
And Brady going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked up by A.J. Terrell. And they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And, Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Ryan, throw out right, taken in by Patterson. Touchdown! Cordero Patterson, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Falcons on just 2 plays have taken the lead. Koo able to connect on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. throwing the touchdown. Here's Koo to kick off. This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Brady going to throw. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Brady to throw on third and one. And he'll get that to Fournette complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7 yard gain there on third and two. Fournette, a first down carry. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about six. The last run got six, now second and four. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And 3 yards there, takes him to the 45. Brady going to try and throw on third down. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. They'll run it with Jones. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. Brady now on first down. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A reminder coming up in a couple of minutes' time. We'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman, the coach in our EA Sports studios. He'll have a look back at the next-gen stats from this first half of action. And Brady's throw there, incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Fakes the give to Fournette. Now Brady. Here's Johnson with a reception. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
It's a nice second effort we just saw there. I saw him trying to get to the end zone, but a lot of times near the goal line, that second effort can lead to disaster. Make sure you hold on to the football because there's going to be guys swarming when you're carrying it.
Give Fournette another crack, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Leonard Fournette punching it in from a yard away. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point up and good by Succop. And we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And we'll see what they want to do. Just 20 seconds remaining here before the half. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it. Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
On second and goal, Brady. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bucs have taken the lead. Extra point put through by Succop. And that makes the score 14-7. So time enough for a kickoff here. 5 seconds remaining in this first half. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordero Patterson. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. It's Ryan, and he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top, as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? The Bucs with a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Play action. Now it's Brady. Buying time to his left. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down. On play action, it's Brady. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. This is caught by Evans. And he is going to have the Buccaneers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. 1st down, Brady. That's going to be caught. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. Here's Brady to throw. And he's got Gronkowski. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. Going to fake it, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and he's going to get 2. That's great. But from the 15, the risk-reward, it's just not there.
That's so risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're going to start to drive here on the ground with Patterson. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Once more, they turn to Patterson, and he'll get it down to the 47 here. They'll run on first down. Patterson, he takes it down to the 42, a 5 yard run. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. They go play action with Ryan. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Vita Vea, his second sack of the night. So the sack pushes him back, and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. Here's Ryan. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Vita Vea in there to get him yet again. That is his third sack tonight. They can't figure him out. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. They're going on fourth down. It's Ryan. He completes this to Russell Gage. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. He's got a man. It's Tajay Sharp. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Ryan. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Again, Ryan. And it's caught. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
You can already start to hear this crowd. They're saying, go, go for it.
Yeah, have we ever been at a game where you've heard the crowd go, field goal, field goal?
No, I have not. That's a good point.
Yeah, they always want to go for it, and I think they've got the right idea right now. The way they've moved the ball in this drive, I wouldn't stop that ball.
Ooh, touchdown, Falcons! Kyle Pitts, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury, and it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run, and he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
And he will get into the end zone to shave two more points off the deficit. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Second and 10. Brady gives this one off to Jones. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. The Bucs try it on fourth down, but come up empty. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. On first down, it's Patterson, and it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. A quick throw here out wide to Pitts. Touchdown! Kyle Pitts, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Falcons have retaken the lead.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets a head of steam going. And as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it. He's at the 50.
Do you have one of those charts that tells you to go for two or go for one?
I don't. I know you do. But I don't care what the chart says there. You got to kick it, right?
I agree totally, because somewhere the chart's going to, something's going to pop out of the chart and say, hey, man, just kick the extra point here. You're in good shape. I think they were chasing points there when they didn't need to.
Yeah, trying to get a little bit greedy, take the lead in the fourth quarter. Now they still trail by one. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front, and then maybe a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football. 2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. But I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Now Leonard Fournette. He'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
On 2nd down, here's Fournette. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
You know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. On 3rd down, here's Jones. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
Nice job there finding room to maneuver, and he worked his way into another 1st down. And look, they had great field position to start, but boy, they've done a nice job taking advantage of it.
Now they're just hoping to cap it off. And now a jet sweep. This is Evans with it. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. And a good gain here of 9 from the 19 down to the 10.
I thought that was a good call. Passing situation on second down, they hit him with a draw instead and pick up nice yardage.
Yeah, because the draw, they're thinking pass when they see that initially defensively, right?
But you know, in today's NFL, most of the time on second and long when it's a passing situation, pass rushers are on the field and they're only thinking one thing, get to the quarterback. And oftentimes you can bypass them with a running play.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. Escaping the pressure right. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. So they get pushed back to the 11. And here's second and goal. Brady to throw. Flushed out right. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now. How about the call to come with the blitz there in this situation?
And some of those calls happen just because of what they do on offense. And when they send out a number of people in the pattern, sometimes they'll just make a change on defense. Say, okay, we'll come after you instead. And that's exactly what they did.
Going to go down. Sacked right around the 17. Now the timeout will be called, so they're in field goal range with 3 seconds left. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through. And they have regained the lead. So fire the cannons. It's a victory here for Tampa Bay. And they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot. But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say good night from Atlanta.